Good to see you, recruits. Afraid I can't open this door for you yet. The Desert Ranger in scarred but spotless combat armor stands at attention before you. The doors of the Ranger Citadel. He gives you a friendly salute. Welcome to Ranger Citadel, recruits, but the General ordered me to not let you in before you finish your first investigation. And I need to be a hard ass or a kiss ass in order to make a comment. Unfortunate. Catch you later, recruits. A kindly older woman in standard issue ranger garb. She seems occupied, counting goods and organizing crates. Aside from the clothes, she's the picture of a loving grandmother. You could swear she smells faintly of fresh baked cookies. Well, hello recruits. Welcome to Solvig's Sundries. Happy to trade whenever you like. An honor to make your acquaintances. Always nice to see new faces around here, and a pleasure to make sure they have everything they need before they head out into the big bad world. So you can outfit us? Well, with essentials as tough to find as they are, I can't just give them away for free. Believe me, I wish I could. But we keep our prices as close to cost as we can for our rangers. You can stop by for the basics whenever you're in your area, and once you get clearance to enter the Citadel, you'll get access to some of our more valuable goodies. You'll have to talk to Sergeant Melson about that when you get inside. What's Sergeant Melson like? Oh, he's a great friend, a great quartermaster. We'd all be eating sand and wiping our asses with cactus flowers without him. The Ranger Citadel, what about it? I do love this place nowadays. Used to be full of some kooky birds back when I was younger. Fellows seemed to worship pre-war junk, even if they didn't know what it was. And they wouldn't share none of it. Well, I wouldn't get too judgmental. I'm sure they thought they were doing right. Well, it's nice to meet you, Solvig. What's your story? Oh, it's not so interesting. I grew up in a village near here, but I was already a grandmother twice over when the Desert Rangers moved into the Citadel. I saw how much good the Rangers were doing, and I wasn't up to much with my children moved to other villages to start their own families. It was a little unconventional for an old lady to go through basic training, but I pulled my weight and earned a star. I may not be too useful in forward operations, but I've got lots of experience in keeping people well fed and well clothed, and I can run a drill press with the best of them. So General Vargas has helped me and Sergeant Melson run the supply. And I help Captain McCaptain in the workshop now and again. What's Captain McCaptain like? She's the smartest person I've ever met, bar none. She can whip up laser beams and water purification systems like I whip up pies. Okay, what do you have to trade? So she has goat hide armor, a leather jacket, a shoddy radiation suit, a FAMAS, an M14, a sawed-off shotgun, a wooden staff, the Midnight Special, which is a pistol, a scorpion, a nail board, a makeshift machete, some TNT, and just overall ammo. Now, let's see what he's got. I, from experience, know that without ammo, well, you don't go very far, to be honest. I think that right now my characters actually don't have any money on them. So I'm going to sell some of their cigarettes. Now, in the past, I've never really noticed that selling cigarettes or not, it never really has like a negative effect on a character. But I know that having no fucking ammo has a negative effect on the character. So what we're going to try to do is we're going to buy, let's say, 20 rounds. And how much have we got? Okay, it was $60. So we're going to buy 10, some ammo, and hope that that does us, at least for a little while. Yeah. Those will do you right out there. Lovely to meet you, Team Echo. Come back again real soon. Hey, Echo. Mind picking up that can over there for me? There's some water in there. tin cans and goats usually go together. Your instincts are telling you that you might not want to steal from this goat's next meal. He headbutted you right in the butt. Well, this is how I feel about that. Why would you do that? I love that goat. You're jerks. Joel Phoenix fires a burst through his SMG with a loud rat-a-tat-tat. Taking care of a lame Shelton Fraser Jr., pegs Arbuthnot the goat, doing 12 points of damage, blasting it into chunks of steaming meat. That might have been a little mean.
God damn it, Ace. Sorry about the waterworks. I'm still pretty broke up over Ace. I'm Angie. You kids must be the new recruits old Vargas trained up. Lord, y'all just babies.
We saw your Ace's funeral. You knew him well? They all hurt, but this one, man. Ace wasn't even a ranger, not at first. He worked as a driver and mechanic up in Vegas. And when base Kochi started sending its death machines into the desert, he sent Ace south to recruit robot fighters. We met him, and he'd pissed somebody off out there, and they locked him up. We sorted this out, and he started running with us, helping us fight Kochis, and never stopped. Vargas eventually gave him the uniform and the hat, but I don't think he ever formally signed on. He was just always there, and now he's... God damn it, Ace. I knew his swarm was trouble. I knew it. You thought Ace's mission was trouble? He was working on the same thing Vargas has you working on, trying to track down radio signals from beyond the edges of the map. It all seemed a bit boring and scientific to me, but then Ace started saying he thought someone was following him. I asked him to let me come with him, and I met him at the Round Nomads to give him the repeater units, but he told me to go back to base. Said he was just jumping at shadows because those radio broadcasts had spooked him. I should have gone with him. Why didn't I go with him? Do you know any more about these repeater units? I really don't know the details. It's all a bunch of mumbo-jumbo about transmitters and north-south axis and signals bouncing off the clouds. You're better off asking Woodson about it. He's our radio genius. You think we're babies? Sorry, but you are as cute as little kittens. You remind me us. You remind me of us, Snake, Razor, Thrasher, and me, back when we were just starting out, thinking we were going to save the world for the future, thinking none of us would never ever die. Sorry, don't listen to me. Youth is good. Optimism is good. If we all started out worn and jaded just like me, nobody would ever try to change the world. So you kids go ahead and give it a go. Maybe it'll work this time. What do you know about General Vargas? Better than he'd like. Back in the day, the General was the craziest of us all. But somehow, after we brought down the base, he became the sanest. Now he's running the whole show and doing a damn fine job. Well, I'm still walking patrols and answering radio calls. Shows you how much ambition I've got, huh? Where's Quartz? Man, not sure I can recall. Haven't been out that way in ages. Don't even know if it's still on the map. Ask Thrasher, he'd know. Where's Thrasher now? You better call him Gilbert now. Funny, back in the day, he just seemed like this big old growly bear, strong as an ox and just about as articulate. But then he got all torn up during our fight with the robots on base Kochi's, and he couldn't go out and patrol no more. Any other commander would have handed him his walking papers, but Vargas doesn't dump old friends. So he started working in the museum, and wouldn't you know it, it turns out the old bear has a knack for cartography. He's been gradually mapping our little corner of the wasteland ever since. Who'd have thunk it? Have you heard any of these strange broadcasts? Ace played me some of them before he died. Hard to make out a lot of it, but what I heard made my hair stand on end. Some guy talking about turning men into machines or machines into men or some shit. But the crazy thing was, then he starts talking about us, the Rangers, saying we're the cause of it all, the trouble in the world and everything else, and we need to be wiped out so his glorious future can be born. I mean, who is this guy? Where is he? What the fuck does he have against us? Tell me about the Round Nomads. Could be a nice little place if the Atkinsons and Turbicans would kiss and make up. I can't even remember what it's all about. But between them, they got enough old railroad tech that, if they worked together, they could give this area a real transportation system. Instead, it seems like they just want to blow each other's heads off. Idiots. Okay. Do you know Woodson? The radio technician, Wade Woodson. Sure do. He's the guy that makes sure you can hear Vargas when you're out on the patrol. Keeps all the machines running and the signal clear. It also took your ear off about circuits and frequencies, and I don't know what else if you like. I don't know what else if you learn him, but be nice to him. He's your lifeline to the base. So General Vargas used to be called Snake? Well, like I said, he was one wild ass son of a bitch back in the day, but I think the weight of his responsibilities has kind of squashed that out of him now. He hasn't been in a decent bar fight in, shit, a decade maybe. What was Space Coast Cheese? An old military facility, from beyond the war, and the biggest fight the Rangers ever had. There was some crazy computer in there that kept spilling out robots and sending them off to kill people. We had one hell of a fight putting it down, and our stripes that day. Literally, that's when I became Captain Death. A computer was making robots. Yeah, the base Cody's AI. Don't know what was wrong with it. Broken, I guess. It thought everybody was its enemy. Wanted to kill the whole planet. What happened to Hellraiser? He's another one gone. Went out for a patrol a few weeks back and never came home. Don't know if he's dead or AWOL, or gone off to join the Scorpions. All anybody knows is he hasn't called in, and we haven't heard from anybody who's seen him. I miss old Hellraiser like blazes. It didn't talk much, didn't make friends easy. Wasn't big on the social graces. But he was as loyal as they come. And when the shit started flying, he was the guy you wanted at your back. He didn't win that name by accident. Sharp as a razor, scary as hell. Red Scorpions. You weren't briefed on those fucks during your training? Well, let me fill you in. You know when we left the prison and moved here to the Citadel? Well, the Scorpions were the jerks who moved into the prison when we moved out. Just a bunch of raiders back then, but they've been trying to get more organized. Call themselves a militia now. And then they try to act like the Desert Rangers of Eastern Arizona. Well, that's a load of horseshit. A protection racket ain't the same as protecting people. They shake down all the towns for money, and if the locals don't kick in, they smash them up. The Rangers aren't like that. We get on by donations and good old-fashioned scavenging. What can you tell us about Eastern Arizona? Basically everything between the prison and the radiation clouds to the east. There are a few small towns and farms out there, which the Scorpions claim was their territory. Rangers used to patrol that area before we moved here, and we know it pretty well. But a lot can change in 15 years. Who knows? Maybe it's all as clean and nice and crime-free as the Scorpions say it is, but I got my doubts.
Say, listen. Vargas asked you to look into Ace's death because he thought I was too upset to be professional about it. He didn't want me going off half-cocked and shooting up all of Arizona looking for his killer. But I gotta find this guy. Ace and me, well, we've been fighting side by side for nigh on 20 years. I'm not letting him die unavenged. So, well, I know it's going against orders, but if you let me tag along and be in at the kill, well, I'll help you find your feet out there. Maybe give you a few pointers along the way. I may be old and slow, but I know the Wastes like the back of my hand. What do you say? Cool. No need to tell Vargas why I joined you. If anybody asks, I'm just helping you get oriented, all right?
Well, folks, that's how you go from five members to... Well, so you go from four members to five. Now we have Angela Death with us. She's about level 12, something like that. Whereas these characters, of course, are level 1. If we take a look at our inventory screen, we can see everybody from Christian, Shelton, Maria, Joel, and now Angela. Angela's level 14, everybody else is level 1. She will definitely come in handy later on. Now there's a ranger over there, but it's pretty much time for us to hit the road. Now, this is the world map where you...
Ranger Team Echo, this is Ranger Command. Come in. Roger, Echo One. Just making sure your radio is working. I'll be your dispatcher from here on out. Also wanted to give you a little heads up on your water situation. If you've all got full canteens, you should have enough water to reach the place where Ace died with plenty to spare. If you're going to go exploring, you'll want to fill up again at any oasis you can find. Remember, your main priority is to recover the repeater units Ace was carrying. Once you've got the devices, you'll be headed to Ag Center and High Pool to install them. But we'll talk about that after you acquire the repeaters. We must, of course, bring Ace's killers to justice. But right now, that's secondary to discovering the location of that signal. It is vital that all teams stay in radio contact with me here at the base. We get distress calls from all over our jurisdiction and sometimes beyond. Towns or farms or mines being attacked by raiders, mutant beasts, what have you. We field those calls here and then dispatch whichever team is closest to the problem.
Roger, out.
10-4 Echo 1, carry on. Ranger Command out.
So, as I was saying, this is the world screen where you basically just decide which direction you're going and your rangers, they go for it. Now, it's kind of disappointing, if I'm totally honest with you. I wish this was a game, you know, a lot like Fallout, where you know, you got to do guys everywhere, but it's not the case. You see dangerous rangers approaching your position. You can attack or run. Well, seeing this, this is our first battle, I think I'm going to decide to attack. So here we are, this is just a random area where we've been thrown, where the enemy is currently stationed around. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and get the jump on them and use the free aim. But it means moving my guys up without being seen. And there we go, we are now in combat. Much like Final Fantasy or anything like that that you can think of, you have to take turns with each character, one at a time. Apparently some with Angela. Now because we're all pretty much distance fighters, my best bet is to pick somebody at a distance. Angela screams as she hits a raider cutter for 11 points of damage, putting an end to his screaming once and for all. Now it's going to take too much AP for me to get an attack. There's no point really moving or doing anything else. Well, actually I'm going to put her right here. Next up we have Maria for our first turn of combat. We're going to take a shot at the raider gunslinger, and of course she is our sniper. 77% chance. Maria's aim is true and the bullet strikes a raider gunslinger, inflicting 15 points of damage and tearing its head clean off. Next up is Joel Phoenix. I'm going to take aim at the raider cutter. Oh, that was bad. Not only did my weapon jam, but I fired a burst from his SMG and injured Maria. That's never happened to me before. Now that that's just happened to me, I'm probably not going to try and repeat that. So I'm going to move Shelton over to the right and take a shot. One round narrowly misses a radar cutter. Shelton Fraser Jr. fires a round at the radar cutter, doing 6 points of damage. Now then, it's up to Christian to finish him off with a pistol straight to the head. Had 2 shots, and the second shot, my weapon became jammed. So I've swapped my fists. My gun is jammed, and it would take too much AP to unjam it. Back to Angela, who has decided to take initiative and is not waiting for orders. She screams, "Come and get it, candy ass," as she takes a shot at the raider cutter. The bullets rip into him, inflicting 9 points of damage to put an end to him. So there we go, that's our first... Ooh, nice. That's our first lot of... Excuse me, Just giving everything to who needs it. That's our first leather combat, and I hope that you enjoyed checking that out as much as I did. This game can be pretty infuriating, honestly. There has been way too many times when a weapon has malfunctioned or a character has missed at a very high point. You know, I've had like 90% chance of hitting and the character has still missed. So yeah, expect to see some of that in the future. Now this game is very interactive. I can click on almost anything, and I really don't know how much you as a listener or a viewer of this video as well want to actually hear me describe, but if I click on this body right here, looks like he almost got away. This one over here, what happened here? Why did this have to happen? You know, almost everything I approach, these messages in the bottom right corner will come up. So we're now going to continue on with our journey. Okay, so we're now going to continue on with our journey and make our way to try and find Ace's body. Dangerous raiders attack my position, but this time we're going to attempt to run. Now my skill in outdoorsman gives me a 75% chance to escape this encounter. Success! This wasn't worth the ammo it took to kill them anyway. Now I've discovered an oasis just here, which means I get to refill my water. So I now have maximum water. So what we're going to do, we're going to view the map, and if we're actually on the right path to the radio tower. But if I click that like that, there we go. We've now set our group of rangers automatically traveling along the path. Now unfortunately there is no fast travel, this is basically the only way of travel in the game, so we're now going to enter the radio tower. Citadel Base, this is Echo Roger 1, we've arrived at the target. One.
When you reach the area where Ace's body was found, give it a good going over. The folks that picked him up said it looked like he crawled there. Maybe you can find some tracks leading to where he was attacked. Copy?
Now there's this funny thing in this game where when you talk to the radio, you can actually type anything that you want. For example, I can tell the radio, did you know you're in a video game?
I'm getting gibberish. Say again, over.
And obviously he doesn't understand. Okay. Copy.
I'm getting gibberish. Say again, over.
Yeah, basically.
10-4.